I am going to kick this hat about the room until it is without form and void, and I shall never, as long as I live, wear anything of that shade of green again."
"You've certainly kept your vow pluckily," laughed Miss Oliver.
"It wasn't pluck, it was sheer obstinacy.
I'm rather ashamed of it," said Rilla, kicking joyously.
"I wanted to show mother. It's mean to want to show your own mother. Most unfilial conduct. But I have shown her. And I've shown myself a few things. Oh, Miss Oliver, just for one moment I'm really feeling quite young again. Young and frivolous and silly. Did I ever say November was an ugly month? Why, it's the most beautiful month in the whole year. Listen to the bells ringing in Rainbow Valley. I never heard them so clearly. They're ringing for peace and new happiness and all the dear, sweet, sane, homey things that we can have again now, Miss Oliver. Not that I am sane just now. I don't pretend to be. The whole world is having a little crazy spell today. Soon we'll sober down and keep faith and begin to build up our new world. But just for today, let's be mad and glad." Susan came in from the outdoor sunlight, looking supremely satisfied. "Mr. Hyde is gone," she announced.
"Gone? Do you mean he is dead, Susan?"
"No, Mrs. Doctor, dear, that beast is not dead. But you will never see him again, I feel sure of that."
"Don't be so mysterious, Susan. What has happened to him?"
"Well, Mrs. Doctor, dear, he was sitting out on the back steps this afternoon. It was just after the news came that the armistice had been signed, and he was looking his Hydest. I can assure you he was an awesome-looking beast. All at once, Mrs. Doctor, dear, Bruce Meredith came around the corner of the kitchen, walking on his stilts. He has been learning to walk on them lately, and came over to show me how well he could do it. Hyde just took a look, and one bound carried him over the yard fence. Then he went tearing through the maple grove in great leaps with his ears laid back. You never saw a creature so terrified, Mrs. Doctor, dear. He has never returned. Oh, he'll come back, Susan, probably chastened in spirit by his fright. We will see, Mrs. Doctor, dear, we will see. Remember, the armistice has been signed. And that reminds me that Whiskers on the Moon had a paralytic stroke last night. I am not saying it is a judgment on him, because I am not in the counsels of the Almighty, but one can have one's own thoughts about it. Neither Whiskers on the Moon nor Mr. Hyde will be much more heard of in Glen St. Mary, Mrs. Doctor, dear, and that you may tie to.